In this video, we are going to learn about working of JFET, that is Junction Field Effect Transistor, which is a type of field effect transistor that is used in electronic circuits for various applications such as amplification, switching, and controlling current. A JFET is a type of transistor that controls the flow of current using electric field. This is why it is called field effect transistor, because the electric field, that is voltage, at the gate affects the current flow. The JFET consists of three main parts: the channel of JFET, terminals of JFET, and the gate structure. The channel in JFET is made of either N-type or P-type semiconductor material. If the channel is made of N-type material, we call it as N-channel JFET. If the channel is made of P-type material, we call it as P-channel JFET. Next is terminals of JFET. A JFET has three terminals. First is source, represented by S, where the carriers enter the JFET. Second is drain, represented by D, where the carriers lose the JFET. Third is gate, represented by capital G, which controls the flow of current through the channel. It is made of material opposite to channel material, meaning that in N-channel JFET, the gate is made of P-type material. Third is gate structure. The gate is placed on both the sides of channel, forming two P-N junction with N-type channel. These P-N junction behaves like a diodes. These P-N junctions controls the width of channel, which in turn controls the flow of current between source and the drain. Now that we know the basic construction of JFET, let's understand how it works. When there is no voltage applied to the gate, that is VGS equal to 0 volt, the channel between source and drain is wide open. The current flows easily from source and drain through the channel when voltage is applied between source and drain, that is VDS. In N-channel JFET, the current carriers are electrons which move easily through N-type material when the gate is at 0 volt. Now if we apply negative voltage to the gate, in case of N-channel JFET, the negative gate voltage creates reverse bias on the P-N junction between the gate and the channel. This causes a depletion region form at P-N junction. As the depletion region grows, it narrows the channel, restricting the flow of current through the channel. The larger the reverse voltage, that is more negative VGS, the wider the depletion region and the less current can flow between source and drain. If we continue increasing negative voltage on the gate, a point will come when the depletion regions from both the sides of gate meet each other and completely close the channel. This point is called pinch off point, and the voltage at which this happens is called pinch off voltage, that is VP. Beyond this point, even if we increase the voltage between the drain and source, that is VDS, the current remains almost constant because the channel is pinched off. If we apply a sufficient negative voltage, that is VGS, the depletion region within the channel expands to the point where it fully closes the path for current flow between the source and the drain. At this stage, the current is completely blocked, and this condition is referred as cutoff region. In the cutoff region, the JFET behaves like an open switch, effectively preventing any current from passing through the device regardless of drain source voltage, that is VDS. This ability to control current flow makes the JFET useful for applications such as amplifiers and electronic switching circuits. Now that we understand the construction and working of JFET, let's look at some of its important applications. First is amplifiers. One of the main uses of JFETs is in amplifiers. Since JFET produces very little internal noise, they are ideal for audio amplifiers or other sensitive signal applications like radio receivers. Next is switches. By controlling the voltage at gate, we can turn JFET on or off just like a switch. JFETs are used in switching circuits where quick on-off control is needed. Next is voltage control resistor. In some circuits, JFETs can be used as voltage control resistor. By adjusting the gate voltage, we can control the resistance of JFET channel, which makes it useful in circuits where varying resistance is needed. Next is oscillators. JFETs are used in oscillator circuits, which are the circuits that generate continuous electric signal at a particular frequency. These oscillators are used in radio transmission, clock generators, and other communication devices. Next is analog switches. JFETs are used in analog switches, which are the switches that pass analog signals such as audio signals. They are often found in audio mixing and audio processing equipment.